Hello everybody, my name is Walter, and today I want to show you how you can turn my 3 and 5 wide double arch doors, which I showed you in the previous tutorial, into full tall double vault doors. So essentially how to take the double arch doors and add a corresponding segment at the bottom to make it a tall double vault door. I will show you how to build this 3 wide version, and I will also show you how to build this 5 wide version here. And that's basically what I want to show you today. With that out of the way, let's quickly talk about the sizes. So the sizes are the same as for the double arch door and the double wedge doors they are based on, with the exception that now the 3 wide version is an additional 2 blocks higher, or to be more precise, the opening is 1 block higher, or the floor is topped by 1 block, and you have an additional block at the bottom. For the 5 wide version, the opening is 2 blocks higher, or the floor is topped by 2 blocks, and the height is below the floor pretty much the same, so the entire build here is only 2 blocks higher as before. And that's the sizes. Now let's get quickly to the resources. So for the 3 wide version, you're gonna need additionally to what you would need for the corresponding wedge door, a single piece of redstone dust and 6 redstone torches and 6 sticky pistons. And obviously some building blocks. And for the 5 wide version, it's some building blocks, 7 obsidian blocks, 6 nine blocks, 2 redstone torches, 7 repeaters, 4 observers, 12 sticky pistons and 6 normal pistons. And that's pretty much all you're gonna need. So let's quickly show you how to build those 2 doors here. Okay, so let's start with the 3 wide version. For that, the first step is to actually build the 3 wide double arch door, as you can see here. And when you're building this, make sure that you build it as if the floor were 1 block higher than it is in the end. That's the first step. Then the second step is to actually remove the entire floor of this build here. Then we need to move down this block here below the torch, like so. Then we need to move down this row of blocks except for the last one of the redstone wire, like so. Then redstone dust on top of those, torches on the front and back of the 3 in the middle, and then sticky pistons on top of those. Like so. Then blocks all around. And now let's simply place a lever here and turn it on. And as you can see, the door is more or less finished. The last part is actually filling in an obsidian block here where the slime block is involved. And then we can fill in the rest of the floor and of the walls with normal blocks. And once you've done that, the door is finished. So the last part, if you want, is to relocate the lever a bit. For example, let's put it to the front here. Now you must be careful that you don't place it right here, otherwise you would butt power this piston down there. So you will have to have a bit of a distance here. And that's it. Just make sure that the wire is still running into this block here and you're not accidentally powering any of these pistons here. And that's the 3 wide version done. Last part is filling in the rest of the walls and the floor, like this here. And with that, the 3 wide version is done and it's time to get to the 5 wide version. Okay, so now for the 5 wide version, the first step, similar to before, is to first build the 5 wide double arch door. When building this, make sure that you build it as if the floor were 2 blocks higher than it shall be in the end. So basically we will drop the floor by 2 at a later point. And once you're sure that works, ensure that you have access to the first or bottom most module and the rest of the bottom part before you can actually get started with the changes. So the first thing I would recommend is actually removing this floor here. Once you've done that, it's time to grab the lever you just removed, and on the side with the three sticky pistons here at the bottom module, not with the normal pistons, but with the sticky pistons, search for this block here, which is powered by this torch down here, and has a torch directly on top. Put the lever here and turn it on. So now, even if you remove this torch down here, this torch will not turn on. Otherwise, the whole thing here will break a bit. Anyway, once you've done that, let's actually remove this torch here and replace it with some redstone wire. Then remove this redstone wire here, place a block down here, and place a torch on top of it. Then remove this block. Then let's go, and behind this block here, we need two blocks down here. Remove this block here, and then move those two repeaters diagonally down, like so. We still need this block here. Then the next step is to actually move this block with the comparator, the two hoppers with their content, and the two blocks behind this with the torch and the redstone wire diagonally down in this direction. And it should end up looking like this here. Now, let's remove the lever again, and let's go to the back side and place the lever here, turn it on. Now we are doing more or less the same, so first, let's remove the torch down here, place the redstone wire on top. Remove this redstone wire there, then a block down here with a torch, then remove this block here, and then once more move this comparator with the block, the two hoppers, the two blocks behind them, and the torch and the redstone wire diagonally in this direction. And the end result should look like this here. Once you've done that, you can remove once more the lever up here. And now we can actually remove quite a bit of the blocks here in the center. Leave that for now. And let's place a few blocks like this here, then go down and place a block diagonally down there. Put down three redstone wire, and now we can test this side out. So let's simply put a lever here and turn it on. And that's what we want to see, and the retraction should also work. And that means that we have correctly modified this side, which means now we go to this side here. So now for this side, we first need to remove a few things. That is first this obsidian block here, then this repeater here, the redstone wire, this comparator, and this redstone wire. Then this block here on top of the former redstone wire. And then we can actually remove the rest of this setup here, so the two hoppers, and this piece of redstone wire there. Then grab the comparator you just removed and place it where the redstone wire down there was. Next, behind that, we need the two hoppers facing each other like so, going in the opposite direction, then this block we left over. Then, below this, we need a U-shape of three blocks, as you can see here. Put down two torches like so, a repeater on two ticks in this direction, then another torch on top of this block, a repeater on four ticks here, a full block right there, then place seven items inside of this hopper here on the front, and that's pretty much this side done. So let's give it a test run by powering this block here. And that's looking good. And if we depower it, you should see everything flatten out, which means that this side is now also modified correctly, which means that we now can finally get to adding the new circuitry. Now for this downwards archway, let's first start with removing the levers from before, if you haven't already. Then we need to connect both sides. For that, start on this side here with three blocks in a row, then go up with an obsidian block, down and another three in a row there. put down two redstone wire here and here. Then a repeat on 4 ticks, taking an output from this obsidian block there. And in the opposite direction, a repeat on 2 ticks there. This block here is essentially our input from now on. So let's place a lever on the side of this block. Then we need a sticky piston diagonal to the obsidian block and next to this block here with the first redstone wire. The same on this side. Then in between we need observers facing outwards and then connect those with two rows of three slime blocks each. Next to the front and the back, three normal pistons, like so. And then on this side here with the sticky pistons, let's quickly add another two sticky pistons at the front and the back, like so. Then an observer looking at this torch here with a full block to the face and the same at the back. Then down here we need two blocks like so, a repeater taking an output from this torch in one tick. The same on this side. Then here we also need our two sticky pistons at the front and the back. Then diagonal to those torches here, a block, followed by another block, block up, block down. Redstone wire here and here. A repeater on three ticks there. The same here. And with that we are pretty much done, so let's simply place a couple blocks here in front of the pistons and on top of this setup here. And let's power everything. And that's looking good so far. Now let's see if it also retracts properly. And that's also looking good so far, which means that we can now start placing the last few obsidian blocks in the floor here, wherever the slime blocks get in contact with. The same is true for this slime block here, and those two slime blocks here and here. And the rest can be filled in with normal blocks. So let's quickly do this. And when I'm sure it works, I will start replacing them with something that looks a bit nicer. And the closing works and it also opens properly. So with that we are pretty much finished, which means now it's time to beautify the thing a bit, make sure that everything is closed up and also to relocate this lever here. And voila, so now everything is looking quite nice and works properly. And the lever is also relocated, so we are pretty much finished with that. One thing I need to mention here, which I forgot a bit, is that you need to be careful when you're powering this line here, that you don't accidentally connect it with this line over here. So the best way I found is to have a block down here and a repeater in this gap here. That way you can simply power the entire thing via a redstone line running into this block here. There are other ways, but you should avoid putting some redstone wire here and going down diagonally, because this redstone wire here would actually debut this piston here, which would be a problem when the entire thing is trying to close up. So this is the best solution I was able to find here. And with that we have finally reached the end of this tutorial about my 3 and 5 wide tall double vault doors. I hope you enjoyed this little tutorial and well, see ya!